Hello, it's Keith here, and this is the first in the simple series of my 68000 assembly programming tutorials. In this series, we look at a different system each week, we do a simple task, and we try and do it within a single assembly file. The idea being that if you just started with assembly and you want something as simple as possible to see a common job done, that should help you out. And if you're trying to work with a different assembler to VASM, then you'll have as little code as possible to convert to your assembler if there are differences. Now, today we're going to be looking at the x68000, and we're going to learn how to draw simple bitmaps on that system. On every system in this series, we're going to do the same tasks. First, we're going to do an 8x8 tile or a small sprite, depending on the system, depending on if it's a tile sprite or bitmap system. And then after that, we're going to do a 48x48 graphic of our Chibico character, the mascot for this series. So we're going to do two things, a very simple small one and a much bigger one. And hopefully these will give you some idea of how you can do bitmap sprites and graphics in your own games or programs. So let's go over to today's source code and let's see it in action. Okay, so here's the example for today. We're just going to fire it up first and just check it really works. Okay, and so there's our smiley face. And so if we just close that, and then here is the more advanced version. And you can see we've got our Chibico character just here. Okay, so let's have a look at the source code today. Now, the code we're going to be looking at today is based in, to some extent, on the Hello World series, not too much in this case, but if you need to see the absolute total package of how to go from an assembly file to running on an emulator, please look at the Hello World series as well, because I'm going to assume you know the fundamentals of that, or you are just going to use my tutorials, because you can download the development tools, the scripts I use, and you can just literally take this, hopefully, and hit F6, hit enter on the x68 option, and you will see what we've got just here, which is a running example. But as I say, if you need the full package, please go and see that episode as well. Now, we're going to go over things fairly quickly here because I'm just trying to get you to the point of seeing the code running. We're not going to go into every single line and what it does here, but essentially what we're doing here first is we're turning on our screen and we're defining the proportions of the screen. Now, the x68000 has a variety of different screen options, and we're using the 256 by 256 option, and it's 16 colors. Now, ideally, I would usually do 256 by 192. That isn't an option on this system. It actually uses a square screen of 256 by 256, 512 by 256, or 512 by 512. So 256 by 256 is the best of those in this case. So that's what we're using here. If you're using a different option, you would need different settings in this case, and you'll need to check out my website. On my x68000 page, I've got the details of the other settings for the other modes here. So we just need to pipe each of these values to the various hardware registers here to turn on the screen. Next, what we need to do is we need to define the color for our character and our background. So we're defining with these registers here, E8 to 000 onwards are the different colors, and each color uses 5 bits for the blue, red, and green channels here. And this is defining the color of our Chibico character as required. So that's a black color, that's purple, and cyan and white. So that's the 4 colors our character uses. Now, this first example is actually just a little smiley, and it's included here. The screen format on the x68000 is very easy for us to work with. Basically, each color, being a color from 0 to 15, is using a single nibble here. And so this is color 0, this is color 1, and if you look, you can maybe see a round smiley in color 1. And the smile layer is in color 2, and the eyes are color 3. So very easy to view format here. And that's our bitmap data inside the assembly file. Now, when we want to actually draw something to the screen, we need to calculate the memory address of the screen. And this getScreenPos will take an X and Y position, and it will calculate the screen position for us in memory. Now, the formula is just here. Effectively, what we need to do is the screen base is C and 5 zeros. That's the start of the screen in memory. And we need to multiply the Y line by 1024. Now, even though the screen is 16 color, actually, each pixel uses a different byte of memory. Basically, the top nibble does nothing. Effectively, what we need to do to calculate the memory position is add the screen base here to the Y position times 1024 plus the X position times 2 because of that layout. So this will calculate our screen position, and we do this first to get the memory address that we need to write to. It returns a 6 as the memory address here. And then all we need to do is we need to transfer the bytes from our bitmap, which we saw before, and we need to transfer all the lines bytes for each line, four bytes but 8 pixels, to the screen. Now, because each byte of our source data has 2 pixels per byte, but the screen has 1 pixel per byte. We're loading in twice from the source data, and we're writing to 2 separate screen positions here, auto-incrementing after each one here. You see we're auto-incrementing. So we're loading in from the source memory, rotating to the right 4 bits here, and then we're writing it, and then we're loading it in, and we're just writing it again without another rotation or a mask, because that top nibble does literally nothing. It's completely ignored by the screen hardware. So that will draw a single pair of pixels, a single byte from our source data. We're then just repeating until we've done the entire width here. Once we've done a full line, we add 1024 to our screen memory address. We've actually restored our screen memory address from before we were doing these increments, because we're basically going across the screen and then jumping back, going across the screen, jumping back like a typewriter. And adding 1024 moves us to the direct line below the one we calculated. So that will draw the entire sprite, basically. You know, this is the internal loop, the horizontal loop as we draw across. And then this is the vertical loop as we draw down like that. And that's all it takes to draw that little smiley. Very, very straightforward. And because basically the screen is so simple, and because we are actually having to do 2 loops to draw a small sprite, the procedure to draw the larger Chibico character is exactly the same, would you believe? Really, there's very little difference. So if I just accelerate that, there's our Chibico. Let's get it over there. And in this case, I've included a file because it was a bit too big to include in line. So we're using this file. It's actually in the same format as the MSX. That's why it's called a raw MSX. And this hasn't changed. None of this has changed. And honestly, the only change here is the size of the sprite. You can see it's now 48 tall and 48 wide. We're doing 2 pixels per byte, so we're dividing by 2 there. And the rest of the code is exactly the same. Now, really, the only thing we need to worry about is where are we going to get this bitmap from? If we've got an image, how are we going to create a valid bitmap? Well, what I can offer you is my free open source Aku Sprite Editor. This is what I use in all of my tutorials. Everything in my tutorials that's an image file was exported with this. So we can just create or paste an image into here. And then if we go to 68000 and we go to x68000, save raw bitmap here. This will export in the exact format that was needed for today's tutorial. So if you create your own 48 by 48 bitmap and replace this file, you should be able to see that bitmap on the screen. And of course, if you want a different size, you just need to change these parameters here, and that should all be done for you. Would you believe it? That's it. That's really how simple it is getting a bitmap onto the x68000 screen. Now, of course, we do need to know how to create the X file and build the disk images. All of that's in the Hello World series. So please go ahead and check that out if you don't know how to do that and you want to know. Well, I hope you found this interesting. If you have, please like and subscribe, because that really helps, you know, helps with Google Analytics ranking me up in the search results, and it also helps my motivation. I've also got a forum if you want to chat about programming assembly or just retro games in general. It's on the Chibi Akuma's website, or you can go to learnasm.net now. That's my new URL that's super easy to remember, hopefully. But anyway, I hope you enjoy the X68000 and programming in general. Thanks for watching today, and goodbye.